Hi, Stephen Nevada Music. In this video, we're going to show you how to assemble a Roland HP504 digital piano. All you'll need is a posi drive screwdriver. So Roland HP504 comes in two boxes. Very simple to assemble. KSC 66, this is the stand, so there's just the base plate, the two sides and the back panel on that box. And this top box here, this is quite heavy, might take two of you to cart this around. This is the piano ready assembled. So the first thing we need to do is to assemble the stand. It's very simple again, comes in the four pieces. Have two sideboards, and again, you see on the top brackets and simple screws. And there's one for the left, and one for the right. We have the large back panel piece, again, all with simple to assemble brackets. The last piece will be pedal stand, and you'll see a couple of wires there, so that's the connection to the piano, the main unit for the damper pedal assembly. And you'll see also a height screw there, so you can adjust that and screw that down so the pedals are nice and sort of firm. You'll notice there's plastic on these, they'll come off. Also in the stand box, a nice simple to understand assembly. There's not much to assemble. It's the two side plates, the back, the pedals, four long screws, six short ones. So that's the headphone hook. Comes with a couple of these little tiny screws so you can leave some headphones just underneath it, and a little bag of screws. Now, top tip, they say if you can insert them all hand tight to start with and then go round and firmly tighten it up afterwards. That just gives you a room to play when you're putting the piano together. So the easiest way to assemble this is to lie it down like this so you can work from this side. You've basically got to put four screws, two in there and two in there. And there's the two holes there. And just inside, so you can rest this down on this back with the pedals facing up. If you work from this side, it's the long screws, there's four of those. So pop it through the hole and then find the hole and just get it finger tight. Once you've got the two sides attached, go back to those screws and tighten them up, make sure they're nice and tight. Then we need to lift it up. Now you can't just do it on one end because it will twist, so either two of you, or if you've long enough arms, just lift that up like that. Now we're ready to attach this back panel. Now already fitted are two bolts here and here on the piano. And quite simply, they will slide in to there to start with, and then we'll fix the other parts in. So there we go, that's that one and that one in place. Next thing to do is to get the four bolts for these dudes. Once you've got all those four bolts located, you can go ahead and do the final tightening up. So there we go, that's our stand now put together. We'll need to unbox the main piano, which will now just simply rest on the top and attach with a couple of bolts. So you'll need a little bit of space to work around it, so don't quite put it where it's going to finally end up yet. There we are. What I've done is I've slid the piano out of its main box. Again, two of you will be needed to do this. It's very well packaged, so don't worry. And in there you'll also find the power supply and the manual and concert pieces book. Cool, so there we are. We've got the piano out of its box and all the packaging off it. Whilst we're on the bottom here, this is where the this will fit into the back of the stand. You'll just rest it over and then you'll slide it in. So you'll pull it forward on the stand. And here's the other sort of screw mounts there. Here's the USB sockets. There's two of those, one for memory, one for computer connection. And down at the other end, there's the twin headphone sockets. You've got a large and a small one there. There's speakers, and this little clip there is the power supply clip. So once you've located the piano on its stand, there's just two more of the small bolts, and if you put your head underneath, you'll find them under there. Again, do them finger tight to start with, and tighten them up fully with a screwdriver afterwards. Next thing to do is put the headphone adapter on. That pops just up there. So we leave it there, now you've got your piano pretty much assembled. A couple of more things to do. Attach this sort of multi-pin DIN lead. This goes into the remote, and again, it goes in vertically. Be a little bit careful because there's multiple pins going in. So pop in like that. Now your power supply comes in two units. Simply plug the figure of eight cable in, and then it's a PSB 7U. Pop that in the DC in socket. Also, whilst we're around the back, you have got jack outputs. Should you wish to run this into maybe a sound system, if you maybe got it in a church or a hall somewhere, or you want to record it via analog, then outputs there. And you've also got a stereo input, ideal for maybe a laptop, iPhone, iPad, computer, or any audio source. If you want that audio to come out of the cabinet speakers whilst you're playing along, a great idea. And again, that will also come out on headphones, so you could, in fair reason, you know, sit there on YouTube and playing along with things while it's on there. So there we go, I hope that's been a slightly useful guide. Last thing to do, underneath the pedals, spin that control, spin the little stand adjuster down so it gives the pedals a little bit of support. And then you've got a three position music rest. You've also got the piano stands there. And again, all these Roland pianos have two positions for the piano cover. You can have it fully back so you can see all the controls. You can bring it just forward to hide all the controls. And again, put that away. A beautiful instrument, easy to assemble, and the ideal piano for any home. In the next video, we'll plug it in, have a listen to the sounds and some of the features. So if you're wondering what the actual piano sounds like acoustically, I've got a little handy recorder here. Let's have a listen. So this is just from the microphone. Got the Nutcracker Suite. I think you'll find it's a beautiful sounding piano. That's a beautiful full range 3D sound. Lovely.